Hi, my name is Nao Adachi. In this video, I will show you how I remove the shadow of a flying drone by using projection mapping and time offset. This technique is useful when the shot is very long, and if you try to remove something by making patches and tracking, you would have to frame hold so many different frames. As you can see, if you use this frame to cover up this area, by the time it gets to this point, the pixel information might not be good enough. So you would have to keep making patches by frame holding again and again. Other methods like content aware fill from Photoshop and After Effects can sometimes get good results in some shots, but I think this technique can be more accurate and better quality if the tracking is good. First, I 3D track the ground and set up a scene with the camera. Here's what I have for the 3D track. So I set up the scene. And I need to align a card with this ground, so I need to make this ground flat. So now I make a card. And align with this ground. Here's what I have. If the ground is not flat, it might work better to create matching objects or mesh from point cloud generator. For example, this area is flat because of this road, but this area might not be flat because of the desert area and the mountain. In this case, I use two cars for the road and the desert area. Next, I set up projection mapping onto the card. And the trick is to use time offset only for projection map texture and the camera for the projection map. So these two. And these time offsets should be exactly the same, so you can just instance it. Also, let's set up the scanline render. Make sure you don't use the time offset for the scanline render. Next, you roto just the area you want to remove. In this case, I roto the shadow of the drone. Then I use this roto to mask our projection mapping element and merge it with the original footage. Finally, you tweak the time offset so that the shadow will disappear from our projection mapping element. What's happening here is that I'm using the previous frame of the camera position for the projection mapping, but the actual camera for the scanline render is the current frame. So the texture is projected into the right place and rendered by the current camera, but the shadow of the drone is not there yet. You should add the blur to the roto to smooth out the edge. As you can see, the car is moving with the drone, so it caused issues. Because the car doesn't require so many different patches like the ground, I just tracked the car and used framehold for a couple of frames to make a few patches. My tracking is not perfect and I just used cars instead of mesh from point cloud generator, so it is a little bit off, but it got the job done. Also, drone footage might have lens distortion, so undistorting the footage might work better for tracking. So please let me know what you guys think or if you have any questions. Thank you for watching.